walked on down the forested hillside to the slowly rising mist of early winter haze. Tired trees smothered in some clinging vine, and woods littered with plastic jugs, old tires, and battered cans of paint. I reached the border of the new six-lane expressway and watched my shadow dance across the base of a 30-foot retaining wall. And crossed high over it all on a catwalk, covered with wire mesh to keep the people from throwing rocks on the cars below. But I love Chrissy on the wall, along with hearts and swastikas. The lifeblood of the city flowing at 60 miles an hour beneath my feet. I say a prayer to the open skies, like a magic arrow, piercing concrete. Overhead, like an arrowhead, a cooper's hawk folds its wings and disappears in a distant country. But past the cold foundations of demolished homes, jutting out of the hillside like old men's broken teeth. Worn cellar stairs leading nowhere except maybe the imaginary beds and living rooms of just faded years. Where the ghosts of conversation, prayers and oaths, and incantations still linger. Each step like a question mark, to which all these ghosts have no reply. And a dry wind blows across the town and sweeps the weeds against the stones. Old man King, come and see. Pass some judgment and let it be. So these children can finally shake free. On a gob of infected spit in front of the X-rated theater, promising unknown passion and forbidden sin. Across the oily river, the city hums and gleams like some silver platinum castle in the sun, where the sun itself split into 10,000 images of burning hungry tongues of flame. And some guy on the corner says, "What you staring at?" And I say, "Never mind, the wizard is gone." Meanwhile, behind curtains of light and shade, a hand moves, but it's really no hand at all.